dribble the time away.
They expected to have everyone against them.
Crowd is on its feet here at Pinnacle Bank Arena, and what an excited group.
Matthew was probably about, I would say, third or fourth grade when he came in and he said, "Mom, am I Indian?"
Came down here battling for some respect.
A lot of people said, "Who is Winnebago? Who are they?"
There's stereotypes against the Winnebago basketball team every year. That they're, they got talent, but they don't got the drive to win.
It's so much more than basketball. It's more of a family thing.
They love basketball here.
Yeah, it's always been basketball growing up.
It felt really good just to do that for the community.
And congratulations, the Winnebago Indians are Class C1 state champions.
Res ball came through.
Winnebago, Nebraska, a lot of it revolves around basketball.
There's usually kids walking around town, walking to the store or something. It's really nice, to be honest. I like it.
Thirty years ago, it had the feel of a run-down rural town. All the businesses were closed, buildings were vacant, and now you come through and there's one of the largest hospitals in the area, and they build a whole new main street and they're starting fresh. It's a great community to work for.
Here it's a little more isolated. You know, to get somewhere, you know, you gotta have a driver's license, you gotta have your car to get there. But here, I mean, there's a gym's always open, and there's three outdoor basketball courts. I mean, they like that. That's what they do.
What else do they have? Most of these kids are living in poverty, and a basketball is something cheap. I think it's something where these kids can get away from their home, and they can go down on that slab, and they can just become one with the ball. And it takes their worries away from home life, schoolwork, friends, peer pressure. I think it's helped. It's a godsend to them as the basketball.
There's a picture at the house. It's me in my uniform, with a little basketball. I don't know if it's, I always just remember that day.
It was kind of rough in the beginning because in junior high, he was, you know, a little chunky. I told him, I said, "We're gonna go to the gym and we're gonna start working out," and we'd do, you know, the lines and run, and he just started sprouting. In junior high, he went through three sizes of shoes just in one season. I've always loved Michael Jordan, and then I just fell in love with Kobe. I mean, just the way he played ball. My sister said, "Yep, Kobe." She said, "Let's name him Kobe." I'm glad that he's fell in love with basketball.
My mom always tells me about when I was younger, I had a lymph node in my neck and I had to get it removed. And she said they did the operation, and like probably I woke up and about 2 hours later, they had a little toy hoop out in the hallway and I was already out playing on it about 2 hours after the operation.
It was probably in Walt Hill at my dad's house. We had a hoop on the garage, and it was about 7 foot, and just sit there and shoot.
It was entertaining, that's for sure. It all started out in good fun. They were just competitive, you know, they wanted to beat each other so bad, and they'd get to the point where they were just about ready to fight, and sometimes you'd have to step in and tell them to take a break.
As they got older, you know, they had to play against each other because Mom, you know, she really wasn't able to cue. I couldn't keep up with them anymore.
Me, I'm blessed. I have a lot of family support. I remember when I was in Head Start, I was probably about 4 years old. I remember my dad give me a basketball. He was teaching me the fundamentals, how to shoot a proper jump shot, look in your wrist and all that.
Back then, we didn't have the three-point shot. But if we did, shoot, I might average 40, 50 points a game, 60 points a game. If I get serious, you know, I tell him, well, pray to God blessed you with your natural athletic abilities. If I get teasing, I say, it's a good thing God blessed you with your dad's natural athletic abilities.
I'm grateful that my dad took time out of his life to teach me.
I've seen kids from when I played, like, my parents would always, like, be kind of their second parents and, like, support them just as much as they support me.
Well, we have this thing called brotherhood. My dad started it. A brotherhood is, like, you're always going to be there for somebody no matter what the cause is, what happened. You're always going to be there. And we form, like, a special bond that can never be broken.
We've been playing together for like almost our whole lives. We know each other's weakness. We know who's gonna, what, if I have the ball, they know what I'm gonna do. If Matthew has the ball, we all know what he's gonna do.
We're basically family, really. I mean, we're all brothers. I mean, we're all just a tight-knit family, I guess. Cause we hang out all the time. We're there for each other.
These boys here have formed that brotherhood, which is the name of our team. When they're not representing Winnebago Indians, we're Bago Brotherhood.
I remember it was our last football game. My mom came and told me, she said, your dad's over there, he's sick, just play your hardest. The first time he went in was in November because his appendix burst. He would always tell me that, I don't want you to be like these other kids. Like, some of them, like, just give up.
You gotta know Craig Cleveland. Man, there's nothing about him. It's all about his boys.
He was one of those one parents that is the only person you can hear just yelling and yelling.
To find out that his dad wasn't gonna come back the rest of the season, it hurt Corey really bad, but we knew that we had to be there for him. We're always there for him, and we'd always tell him it's okay, give him a hug.
He's probably my best friend that I have, you know? We're really close. I mean, that's my brother, you know? And then, I mean, I had to keep him up. I had to say, I'm here for you, bro.
When he got stricken, I went to the hospital to see him. He's like, I said, Craig, what happened? I said, man, T, he said, wouldn't you know it was the day of the Fremont Bourbon game. All I could think about was, I'm gonna miss the game. And he missed the whole season. The love we have for our sons, can't help but have a tear come out, because that's how powerful that feeling is.
It was amazing. All the stories that we had behind us, and these boys knew it.
Matthew had just finished third grade, and David had just finished first grade. Nick had just finished sixth grade, and it was a summer day, and he was out for a ride with some friends, and lost control of the vehicle and rolled over, and he was killed instantly.
You know, I still remember it like it was yesterday.
It was like being in a state of shock. And it lasted, you know, quite a long time. I would say probably a year or two for us to really almost accept it, you know, and try to start moving forward. One of the things the boys did was, you know, used him as an inspiration to push themselves, you know, harder.
We'd always talk about him like, we're making him proud. He's the reason we're doing this. He was a huge reason why we worked so hard. He inspired me a lot. He was a 12-year-old, but he was a humble guy. How did he teach me this much? You know, how did I get this much from a 12-year-old kid?
Questions are being raised tonight on the Winnebago Indian Reservation. That after a special investigation into the tribe's finances revealed the tribal leaders received hundreds of thousands of dollars from the Winnebago's casino over the last 3 years. KTIV's Kaya Gosman spoke.
The tribe was just kind of coming apart. And then we went and played in the state tournament. And I mean, everyone was there, everyone was together. And I think that helped, is still helping the tribe get everything back together.
With all the tensions, with all the stress, rising above all that was huge.
It's a really good feeling to just take some stuff off of people's minds.
Richard to Medina, the three from the wing.
Now, the road back to state has certainly been a long and challenging one, but now the Indians are bringing res ball to Lincoln.
Winship hits again on the baseline.
Yeah, this is res ball, just the up-tempo, fast-paced game. My philosophy is defense first. If we get defensive stops, we get turnovers, we get rebounds, and we can push the ball faster.
Running, quick shots, and hustle.
Keep running and don't stop. You just keep going and keep going.
Oh, my legs are just, I can't really feel them at the end of the game. It's just so, so sore.
I think it's something that's been instilled in them as a young child. Growing up from the time they could dribble a basketball is you share the ball. It isn't about you. It's about the whole team on the court. Running as fast as you can and just working harder than the other team that you're playing against.
Every sport is 90% mental, 10% physical.
Winchett, 90% mental. He said that a lot.
Good ball movement by Winnebago. Winchett got it. Into the defense, and what a shot by the senior Cleveland. Winchett behind the back. Oh, what a spin move. Winnebago wins the district championship and now on its way to Lincoln seeking their first state championship in 75 years.
When we went to the Bob Devaney Center, I was just listening to my music and like I looked up and like it was like an hour and a half before the game and I just seen like maybe 200 Winnebago fans just sitting outside the doors waiting to get in. Like that just gave me the goosebumps.
1, 2, 3, 8, 4, 5, 6, seven.
I think we were the home team, and I just felt like it was pretty much the whole community, whole town was there supporting us.
And Medina has opened up this state championship on fire. Off the miss, Kobe Smith with the putback. And the great crossover by Winchett leads to a three-point opportunity. The slam dunk. And in Cleveland, great alley-oop to Winget, and you know Winget already with Division I looks in just his sophomore season. So here in round one, res ball rolls Wahoo by 16, and Winnebago picks up its first win here in Lincoln.
The Winnebago tribe in Nebraska are very insulted. Good evening, I'm Jennifer Griswold.
And I'm Craig DeGrelli. The team had just won its game at state basketball when somebody on the Wahoo Sports online broadcast yelled this. The party will be pouring onto the streets. Fire, water, win.
When I heard about it later that night, I got a call from a couple of the, well, I would say tribal council members, a couple of the school board members saying not to tell the boys. Do not tell them they don't need this on their shoulders either. And I was like, the way I found out was on Facebook. So I knew they already seen it. I knew that they heard it. They probably listened to it.
I'm going to be honest, like it hurt us. Like man, he's going to say that.
Coach Jeff made the comment, nothing new to me, you know, and it probably isn't. It's nothing new to them. You know, they've been hearing negativity their whole lives.
I said, let's take that negativity this guy said about us, about our tribe, about our people, and let's turn it good and prove him wrong.
Just more fuel. Now we just take it out on Grand Island.
And what a start on day two by Winnebago. They share the ball as well as anyone in the state. Medina with the feet ahead to Winget, and Winget slams it home. Great crossover down the lane, foul, and an opportunity for the three-point play. Off the inbounds play, Cleveland, the three on the way, got it! And GICC will take the timeout.
Go, go, go!
Winnebago in control. So Winnebago rolls here in round two, and now on to the state championship game, just one win away from their first title in 75 years.
NET Sports, Nebraska's home for championship sports, is live from the Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln, Nebraska. And this morning, in Class C1, it's the Columbus Scotus Shamrocks at 22-5, taking on Winnebago at 26-1. And good morning, everybody.
It just hit me like, this is it. This is my last game, and I wanted to go out there and win it for my team.
Corey Cleveland.
I was probably more nervous than any game I ever played.
A 6'5 sophomore, number 21, David Winjan.
I told him before we left, it's a state game, yeah, but if we go down there and we think of it, oh, it's just another game. It's just like how we've been playing all year. We'll be fine.
Let's play basketball. Looking for a great one here.
I had a player after the captain's meeting come up and shake my hand and say, sir, it was very nice to meet you. I had never had that happen before, and I know the gentleman who was keeping book had probably done it for, well, he told me 35 years. He had never seen a kid do that.
And I mean, I've been doing it all year. If we go out and play our game, the refs won't make a difference.
It sounds like something he would do. I mean, he's a really good kid.
You know, all the negativity that was surrounding them at the time, like, it didn't show on the court at all. At all. They could have been playing at the slab.
Jeff Barrage and his Indians came to Lincoln with something to prove.
Yeah, just me and my brothers out there on the court. Just about to get ready to go to work.
Outside to Isaiah Medina, who knocks it down. He has been doing this all tournament long. Another three-pointer. Dalton Taylor with the drive. Shamrocks keep it close. A nice crossover and the floater by David Winget. Winget with it down low. The turnaround, good. That's the senior Matthew Winget. David Winget knocks down the three-pointer. Time now at Pinnacle Bank Arena, and not a soul leaving the arena as dancers from the Winnebago tribe now take the court. The catch and shoot, and buried by Medina. Oh, and a big three-pointer by Grant Long.
Cleveland with the drive and the bucket. Medina lays it in, another bucket for Medina. 18-point Winnebago lead, the largest of the game. They came down here battling for respect, and they have earned it. Congratulations to the Winnebago Indians, the Class C1 state champions.
I know that your father is ailing. There's a big story right up in the paper today in Omaha. He's probably watching. Yeah. You want to send him a message?
Yeah. Dad, this one was for you. I love you. This whole season was for you.
I was going to say, he's
right after I got out of the locker room, I talked to them. As a team, we went over to his hospital and brought the trophy and everything, went to his room.
When you go above and beyond, when you think of others before yourself, you get that blessing. And so that's what these boys do.
On our way home from state, if you come into Wahoo, there was a sign right up against the stop sign, and it said, congrats, Bago.
Came back and people were texting us and on Facebook and Twitter, and like, where you guys at? Like when we came back and we got escorted in by cops.
We came home, the streets were packed, cars lined up. We got a police escort all the way from the other res, Omaha res, and I mean, it was just amazing.
1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, family!
My brother and Corey Cleveland got to talk. Got a little emotional for Corey.
I'm not expecting my dad to be there.
When we seen Corey crying, me and Kobe were sitting back here, and I kind of got teary-eyed myself, because I know if I was in his shoes and my dad couldn't be watching me, man, I'd be crushed.
Seeing the gym pack one last time, not for a game, but for us, it was amazing.
Reaching that goal, a state title, that just meant everything to them, but it meant everything to this community, because everybody that walked through these doors wished they could be a state champion. Just looking at my boys' faces, just their smiles, the joy. They knew they did something special.
We're not satisfied with where we are. We always want to keep doing better, better ourselves.
Right now, there's 4 people that have signed to play basketball somewhere already in my class. And I mean, that's more than has ever came out of Winnebago, you know? And it's just getting better and better every year. So, I mean, college education makes a huge difference.
Matthew Winget, he'll do great things in life. You know, if he doesn't play another game of basketball, oh well, he'll still do great things.
I signed with Midland to go play basketball. So I'm really looking forward to that. I was thankful that they could go down to my dad's hospital and do it with him.
I know I want to get an education and go through life successfully and earn my degree. And I know I can do it, I have the drive.
I just told them that we did it. We did it. We proved everybody wrong. That's what I told them. I said, you guys, we proved everybody wrong in the state of Nebraska. I said, soak it in, enjoy it. Because it's rarely that you'd be part of a state championship team. And I just told them to soak it in.
I mean, the story was just amazing. Like, when I look back on it, we could have just completely just collapsed the first game and just been done because of how much pressure was on us and how much was riding on it. We lost a teacher from cancer. Corey's dad was in the hospital. We had our whatever going on with the tribe, with the council. And I mean, we could have just completely folded, but we held strong, we stayed focused, and we got the state championship.
that's kind of what got them to where they are. You know, state champs was looking forward and moving on and, you know, getting the job done.
Isaiah finished fourth in the entire nation for seniors only for his three-point shooting. If you sit back and think about it, it's unbelievable. Winnebago, Nebraska, Winnebago High School, Isaiah Medina. So he's up there with the best of the best. That was a testimony to his hard work and being in that gym.
They might not realize it now, you know, but years down the road, you know, it's a pretty special deal, you know, especially with your brother.
I know they brought a community together. They made us all proud, and I would hope that everybody gained something from it.
Best group of boys I had. Just the way they carry themselves as men. They want the best not only for them but for this community. They want the best for these kids that are walking these halls. I see if you guys come back, I see some coaches, I see some people that are going to be here for a long time, and building this community to be better. And hopefully those stereotypes, not only for Winnebagoes, but Native Americans, maybe those stereotypes will be gone. That's what we hope for, and that's what everybody hopes for, no matter what race it is.
Res ball came through.